you to put some power in the body, maybe. And you hit it, don't go back, you stay there. Don't go back, you stay there with
well,
her, okay?
Some power in the body.
You're looking good, you're okay, man. You're winning every fucking round.
That's a terrific body punch. You got a lot of leverage into that shot. Look at her rip those shots. That's a good double left hook. This is just a...
Oh, second's up.
A very well-schooled fighter.
You're watching round number five begin. Belinda Lara Puente at the red of his green, Layla McCurta in the black. This is the GBA. Championship. You're watching CSI Sports from the Orleans Hotel in Las Vegas, Nevada. I've given unofficially I'm a kind of free of this four rounds of me.
I actually did. That one round that you know that you thought she always could she could easily win on the one of the judges' scorecards. And the fact that she's varied her attack so well, going to the body with the hook so well, mixing in uppercuts, jabs, straight right hands, and it, you know, it's just been a very varied attack. But now, Lara Puente coming forward with some good combinations.
Wild shots are really letting them rip. Right back and more discipline punching is Layla McCurta to the body of Belinda. Now, McCurta wants to load up a big power shot upstairs. She'd love to catch her. She has Lara Puente frustrated. She's grabbing her, the head's up against her. Nobody's been down, nobody's shaking. The toughness around the eyes of Belinda Lara Puente.
Don't just come in. There she switched to the lefty stance briefly, but that is this fight in microcosm, really.
Round six from Las Vegas. The Colonel Bob Sherman here with Al Bernstein at CSI Sports of the Orleans. Our principals for the TBU Lightweight Championship for the women, Belinda Lara Puente, with her back here right now in the kind of fringe type of burgundy trunks into the right of his screen. Now we're back here, Layla McCurta in the black trunks of the white trim. Both Al and I have McCurta comfortably off the front. This is round six and scheduled for 10 rounds.
Well, the other key point about this change with the women fighting 3 minute rounds is this is a 10 round fight. Neither of these women have ever fought. They fought 10 round fights before, but those were 20 minutes then of boxing. This is 30 minutes of boxing. So overall, there's more boxing for them. And as this fight wears on, we'll see how that impacts them.
There's many people that are weekend warriors go out and do a 20-minute run and then they get 10 minutes on them. You find out just that BS. But look, these are professional athletes, and they're fighting like professionals. There's Lara Puente who decides to open it up a little bit more here now in the sixth round. And McCurta will have none of it. She ties it up.
Right,
she's
back.
She's technically
what
to do.
It's
Vegas.
If you like that style of aggressive fighting, which most people do, they like the sport. Hitting body shots, throwing combinations to the head. It's just, she's fun to watch, and she is very technically sound.
This is the fourth fight that I've done of Lola's, and it's about the third of Lara Puente's. Lara Puente, I like because she's so tough. And Layla McKenna has improved so much. I thought she was great with her aggressiveness in the first two or three fights, and I did fight very early in her career. I haven't seen her in about a year. Boy, she really, really a slick one. A bad tip.
Time. Get in that corner.
If this would stop this fight, they would go to the scorecards.
Accidental headbutt. Okay, get over here.
But he just
accidental headbutt.
Yep, they banged him. Both women hurt, but a bad cut for Layla McCartney. Now, almost always in men's boxing, a cut like this would never stop the fight, but they sometimes view women's boxing a little differently, but they didn't stop the fight.
Quite a bit out of the real stop women's fighting.
Now,
what is this action?
Layla McCarter is acting as if she needs to go after Glenn Larapente. When in reality, we have to assume that came from a clash of heads, but maybe it didn't. And maybe she's worried about this fight being stopped and her losing it. We'll try to get a ruling about whether that was a clash of heads if we can.
Let's go.
I think that's as official as we can get it. And so with that said, Alan,
maybe she just doesn't realize it because she was going after Larapente, in a big way. Maybe she was just doing it to be aggressive. I think she should have been buying time.
This is the sixth round, so we'll see how Luis Tapia works in this round.